So this week has been pretty garbage, like absolute shit. Like, what drop was it? Foam runners, we pretty much got nothing. That was just dog shit, like zero pairs. Yeah, it was pretty bad. But we did end up getting some on the Topes, and I switched to a different bot, which actually worked really well. And then today we had the 700 dropping, which is garbage. Like, no bot work, only manual work. There was like a little glitch on Yeezy Supply's site, allowing manual users to get through a lot easier. All you had to do was spam refresh and you were able to add a size to your cart, but checking out was still a little hassle. But in today's video, I'm gonna show you guys how to set up Mech AIO, which is the bot I use, which caught me a couple pairs of the Taupe 500s. Worked pretty well. I only had one instance and it still worked pretty well. Dash is flopping, everything's flopping. I even tried Prism, I think, on the Topes, didn't work. It's just been a pretty big headache overall on all the sites. But it's pretty typical, there's ups and downs of everything, sites update, and you're not able to cop a lot. So that is a risk, but it is what it is. All you have to do is take your little dollar a day and wait till the next drop. Like, there's always more shoes you can buy. Don't stress out too much. Okay, so first what you want to do basically every single time is make sure your profiles are in. So if you have AYCD or Kodai Essentials, you can just export it out and put it into Mech. If you don't, you're gonna have to do it one by one manually. So let's say Yeezy 1. And if your billing and shipping are the same, you can just click that and it'll autofill it itself. And then just save it, and that's your first profile. So after you have your profile ready, all you have to do is import proxies, put in a proxy list, name it ISPs, custom site, Yeezy Supply, save. And there we have our custom ISPs. So after you've added your proxy list, you wanna go to tools to add your capture harvester. So I would recommend running about one capture harvester per 50 to 100 tasks. But when you're entering each of these capture harvesters, you're gonna wanna name it, let's say YS1, proxy, you're gonna put your proxy in here, and then save. One thing you gotta do is make sure you switch this from Shopify checkout to YS Advance, and then save it. Also, in order to log in, make sure you have your capture proxy right here and you click the YouTube button in order to log into Google. So it's pretty plain and simple, just like every other bot. So after you have your profiles, proxies, and capture harvesters set up, you're gonna want to create tasks. So let's just name this Yeezy 500 or Reezy release, right? Okay, Yeezy Supply, Yeezys. What you're going to want to use is the product link in order to find your product. So you can just go to yeezysupply.com. Basically, the product link will be right here. Once you click on the product, triple click, copy, paste it in, and that is your product. For delays, you want to set it to 5,000. 3,500 is actually a little high. You're gonna wanna set your ISPs, so whatever you want for a 3DS. And then these are the proxies you're using to run your tasks. So let's just set those as ISPs as well. And then basically to create tasks, all you have to do is press the plus button. What profiles you want, if you wanna use all your profiles, just select that. Size, always go random because whatever size you get is profitable. Usually with Yeezys, there's some way and you can profit from it. And then the amount of tasks you want. So let's say you have 100 profiles, you're gonna wanna set it to 5 if you wanna do 500 tasks on this instance. And then you wanna create your tasks. So all my tasks are here. So once you have your task set up, you're gonna wanna turn on advanced cap mode. For hybrid mode, don't even touch it because it's way too CPU intensive. So it might literally crash your computer or crash your Mech.io. So from my experience, there's not much difference in using hybrid mode and not non-hybrid mode. There's no difference, so don't destroy your computer. You don't have to worry about the Chrome browser because that's to open a Chrome browser for that task. So don't worry about it. Just have the advanced cap mode on and that's pretty much it. When the sale starts, just click the play button and you'll be able to start running your tasks and hopefully check out. Pretty easy, pretty simple. Just make sure your capture harvesters are also open. Pretty simple to use. It's just that there's a lot of things just hidden around everywhere. You're just gonna have to find it and just basically do it. Not too hard. Once you have it set up, just play and you are good to go. So this was pretty much my first setup with Mech. My first time running. I ran a couple tasks with ISPs, a lot with Resis, just to make sure if Resis were working, it'd check out with Resis. If ISPs were working, it'd check out with ISPs. Since the last couple drops, there's been a lot of issues. I just tested everything to make sure something worked. So most of my checkouts were ISPs. So during the drop, Mech actually pushed out an update saying that we had to restart our bots. So that kind of messed me up a little bit. Because I didn't see that message until like a little bit later, but we were still able to get through. So I restarted my bot and we were able to start getting past Splash a lot easier. Right before this update, we're just getting through Splash. We had so many errors. So definitely pay attention to the Discord or any Discords while you're running any drop. A lot of people will tell you to restart Mech, or if you're in the Mech Discord, the announcements will tell you restart Mech. Not before long, I restarted. We were able to get one checkout. It was a size like 6 with 4.5 or something like that. It was really good. Though a little bit later, we were only getting sizes between 8 through 11, so it's still good in my opinion, picking up as many sizes as you can. You can always move them locally. If not, you can always hold them for a little bit. With the 500s, usually it's like a 8-month hold and you'll be able to maybe double your money, or at least 50%, or between 50% to 100% after fees on StockX. But yeah, this drop was pretty easy with Mech.io. I was running Dash on the side, but just didn't work at all. It was still having its cookie limit issue. A lot of people had it, but some people were able to check out with Dash, but unfortunately I wasn't able to check out any recently with Dash. So then moving on to Mech.io for easy drops, which has been working pretty well for me. But I would still do your research on what bot is pushing out the update before running for these easy drops now, because Easy Supply has made a huge update on their backend, which basically just like destroyed every single bot, especially for the last drop, the 700, the cyan blues, whatever they're called. No bot worked, but hopefully in the next couple drops we do have bots working again. Basically, I'm gonna wait a little bit before actually picking out what bots are working and what bots aren't, and yeah, I'm just gonna rent those or run those if I have them on the drop and just hope for the best, because pretty much every site now, even Foot Locker, all the foot sites, they're all just acting up in their own individual ways. But eventually we'll get over this rough patch and we'll be able to cop a lot more. So as you guys know, Supreme is dropping its box logo tees tomorrow. This is one of the last couple weeks of Supreme. They're also dropping the jet ski, but we're mainly gonna focus on the box logo because no one's gonna be able to cop the jet ski. But for the highest chance of copping the BOGO, you're gonna wanna run Mech Prime. It is $1,000 right now if you do wanna get a copy, but you can get a rental for around $100 or $80 if you can bargain. But all in all, Mech Prime is gonna be your greatest chance of copping. No other bot works as good as Mech Prime for every single drop. They also made an update, if you guys haven't seen, which is called Browser Headed Mode. So that mode might come in handy for tomorrow's drop, because with the dunks, we saw an additional factor that you had to answer in order to get through checkout. So if something does pop up, a browser will pop up in order for you to either automatically get through it or manually get through it. So But you're gonna have a high chance of copying these BOGOs with MechFrame, but hopefully nothing gets screwed around where MechFrame just doesn't work. If Mech doesn't work, we're gonna see other bots like Cyber, Prism, Kodai, especially Kodai work really well on Supreme. But we were able to get a couple Air Forces this week, the white pairs, which move really well locally. But yeah, MechFrame was literally the only bot that works on Air Forces. Like, the only other bot I can think of is Swift Soul, and whatever Supreme iOS or app-based bot, some of those work, but they only got like one pair or two pairs max. But I think most people flop on the apps because there's just so many people running them and there's unlimited stock. But with MechFrame, there's a set amount of users. Even though the user base is very high, I still don't think it's as high as the apps that are running for it. So before I go, I do want to give a special shout out to my sponsors, Aurora Proxies, Space Proxies, and also Scarlet Proxies. Big shout outs to them for supplying me with some proxies for all of these drops. In addition, I do want to thank Mommy's Kitchen. Insane, I was able to cop a bot for retail recently, so big shout outs to them. If you guys do want to check them out, their Twitter is in the description down below in order to get a chance to join up with Mommy's Kitchen. Really, in all honesty, they are probably your best chance of copping a bot for retail or getting bot literally as close to retail as possible, so please go check them out. In addition, I do want to be as transparent with you guys as possible, so we don't really make that much off of YouTube. So far in the past 20 days, we've made about $61. I don't know if you guys can see that right there on the bottom, revenue earned. But we've made $61. It's not really enough to even purchase a bot, but I am gonna put in some of my own money in order to help you guys out to do a giveaway. So stay tuned for that. Hopefully once we hit 3K subscribers, I am able to have enough and also put in a little bit in order to give away a decent bot. So I want to thank you guys for watching my videos. It means a lot to me, and I'll see you in the next clip. Peace.